Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrolaguy, with another in the series. Well, I just wanted to show you a quick, easy, and inexpensive way to make a crane for your cylinder phonograph. I had an original standoff, and I had the foot, and I had an original bottom tube. Although you can find a replacement for this at Home Depot. They make an aluminum rod that's just slightly larger than this. But it will work. So in any case, you take one piece of upright tubing, and then this is a piece of solid brass rod. And I just put it in a vise and slowly put a nice curved bend in it and slid it down into the shaft. And I now have an instant crane for a phonograph. And you can make this any length you want to. And I just drilled a hole through it, put a hanger in it with a piece of chain. And then this is one of those transmission funnels. I just put a hose on the back of it and put an eyelet on the top so I could hang it. Throw it on the machine and you have an instant phonograph horn. And it actually sounds pretty good considering it's a transmission funnel. This is one of those eBay machines. I'm just playing with it, but I just wanted you to see the crane and to hear this machine. It's a bit noisy, but it sure does run well. So, a really cheap, inexpensive way to get an Edison phonograph up and running. The funnel is light enough to ride directly on the reproducer. But I wanted to build a crane, and I thought I'd do a video on it. And I built a couple of these, months ago, and sold them with the machines. And the nice thing about it, of course, is they're really inexpensive and they're really easy to make. All you need is the actual foot and the standoff. The rest of it you can make out of stuff from Home Depot. Even if you only have hand tools, a hand drill, I mean, you have to drill a hole in this, but even with a hand drill and a steady hand, you can make a nice hole through that, put the chain and the hanger on it, and you're up and running. And as I said, you can make it any height, you can make it any length, you can have it hold almost any size horn that the machine is physically capable of holding. But an inexpensive, easy way to make a crane for a phonograph. And of course, if you don't have a horn, horns are expensive. You know, a reproduction horn is $60 with shipping. This is $3 with no shipping, and you can find it at Walmart. And it works well, it sounds good, it also makes a really excellent recording horn. But the nice thing about it, as far as playback, is it gives a good full sound. It sounds much bigger than it is because of this material. It's capable of, since it's a dense material, it's capable and it's long. It's capable of capturing more of the longer waves, which gives you a fuller, richer sounding recording. And this horn, if you want to call it that, sounds better than any witch's hat horn that you can find. They sound actually quite good. So anyway, this is one of those eBay junk machines. It's up and running. The new crane made a horn out of a Walmart funnel. And just wanted you to see the results. A really simple way to do it. And you go out to buy a crane, and they're $100, and this way they're $15. So, in any case, I just wanted to do a quick video on it. So if you have any questions or comments about anything I've covered in my YouTube series, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thanks for watching.